it's Allie Hardesty. I'm not sure if I'm gonna label this video as a story time or an advice video, but I'm here to talk to you guys about dealing with strict parents and life hacks to get around this. I'm not encouraging you guys to sneak around or lie to your parents, but I'm going to share things that I did throughout high school that I got in trouble for, or how strict my parents really were, how I got around that. I need to start off by saying that there were definitely parents who were way more strict than mine. But honestly, guys, the reason I think it was kind of ridiculous is if you knew me in real life, especially in high school, I was super straight edge. I didn't party. I wasn't going off doing anything scandalous. So that's why it was kind of like, you guys are doing the most. But I also want to say that I don't blame them. There were things I did that might have made them lose trust in me, as well as I think they were just looking out for my safety, because it wasn't always about trusting me. It was about trusting other people based off things that have happened to me when I was younger, and, you know, just safety precautions. But when you're young and you want to go out and do all these things and your parents are kind of like, no, you need to stay home, it sucks sometimes, and it might sort of take a dent into your relationship with them. So I've learned a lot through having strict parents. Today, I can honestly say I'm glad they raised me the way that they did. I'm glad that they held me back from doing certain things and that they kept me grounded, because if I hadn't had that, I think I might have went off and did some things I would have regretted. I think I still would have ended up okay, but you know, sometimes when you're too immature to make intelligent decisions for yourself, it helps when you have someone not letting you do those things. They were strict sort of like in their own ways. For example, they almost never let me have sleepovers. Like, they almost never let me spend the night at other people's houses. I don't really understand their reasoning for that, other than they wanted me to get good sleep. In addition to that, they'd always take my phone pretty much for whatever I did. Like, if I didn't make my bed, they'd take my phone, you guys. And then if I argued with them about it, they'd keep it for like a month. Every single night, school nights, and even on the weekends I did this. The weekends it was like a little bit later, but same sort of situation. They'd take my phone at 8 p.m. sharp every single night. This was even when I was a junior in high school, they did this. So I'd have to put my phone in their room, and if I brought it in at 8:01, I didn't get it the next day. That's how it worked. And so I wasn't allowed to get my phone again until the next morning when I was ready for school and they were awake, because they didn't want me to be up all night. I don't know. And on the weekends it was the same thing. But you know, when you're a teenager, your phone is like your lifeline. You have all your contacts in there, all your plans, and they'd be like, oh, just use the house phone, like have your friends call the house phone. I don't know, I'm like, mom, it doesn't work that way. Like, they don't want to call the house phone, it's weird. Like, can they just, like, people text, people don't even call anymore. And I don't know, that was just tough on me sometimes, because my friends would be hanging out and they weren't able to get a hold of me, or it was just rough, like trying to meet up with places with them, or if I was at school, I needed to ride home or to contact my carpool, I wouldn't have my phone. So that sort of put me in a bind at times. You know, with parenting classes, they said that the crime's supposed to fit the punishment. So if I did something, they would just take my phone. So half the time, I honestly didn't even know why I was in trouble. They were very, very, I don't even know if strict's the right word for it. They just had very high expectations for me, and they expected a lot from me. And I'm thankful for that, because of that, I expect a lot out of myself, and I hold myself to a very high standard, and I know I'm gonna be successful because of that. This started as early as when I got my phone in fifth grade. I had sort of like a little flip phone for safety to call them or something with little minutes on it. But then into middle school, you know, I got better phones. Like, I had the Rumor. That I remember when the Rumor was like the phone. That was like the phone to have. I had the Rumor. And I would always get my phone's water damaged. Like, my brother and I, we'd always accidentally put them through the wash when we were like in sixth grade. And so I would keep the phones for whatever reason, like the water damaged ones, like I just had them. And one time I got in trouble, don't remember why, but my mom took my phone and she ended up having it for like 2 months, something ridiculous like that. This was in seventh grade. And when I had to turn my phone into her to give it to her because I was grounded, she would even lock them in the safe, you guys. She wasn't messing around. Like, she wouldn't just hide them where I could find the phone. She would lock it in the safe that she had in her closet. And so I gave her the water damaged phone, and was really had my phone the whole time for those 2 months. And I don't even remember how she found out that I had the phone. But then I was in even more trouble. And then I couldn't do that when I got the iPhone, because I didn't have any fake water damaged iPhones. So what I used to do, you guys, I did this with like 3 different phones. So I would take my dad's iPod and download a text-free app and make a new account every night and just text like under the covers when everyone was asleep. I got caught for this like my freshman year. I would take her phone at night because I knew the password, download a text-free app, make an account, text my little boyfriend freshman year, and then afterwards I delete everything, clear the history, delete the app, put it back in the same spot. And one time she caught me because I fell asleep texting him, and she came in my room and she saw I had her phone, and that wasn't very good. They're also we go on family vacations every summer, and one summer we were at this lake house in Michigan, and someone had left an iPod there, like it had been there for years, like way under this bed in one of the rooms. And so I took it, finders keepers, and I used that for a couple years until I accidentally broke that. That sucked. Strict parents create sneaky children, so I always found ways around them taking my phone. Mid junior year, they stopped being as strict when it came to things like this, but they were still very strict about where I went and with whom and for how long. Like, they still didn't really let me sleep over at people's houses. And when I started driving, they didn't let me drive to certain areas that they thought were unsafe. Like, I was pretty much allowed to drive myself to the gym, in our neighborhood, my best friend's house. That was it. They wouldn't let me drive to my boyfriend's house. They wouldn't let me drive to like the city right next to us. In addition to this, my parents would track my phone everywhere I went, so I couldn't really get away with a lot of stuff unless I left my phone. But then if they called me or texted me, like, you know. So my best friend and I found that you can actually set up in your settings to get your calls forwarded to another person's phone. So if my mom calls my phone, it'll automatically go to my best friend's phone, and then I'll just answer like, hey, you know, like she won't think anything of it. So we had to do that a couple times. I promise we weren't doing anything scandalous. It would just be like we were going to get a milkshake, like, and it was 20 minutes away. So my mom thought that was too far to drive. So I just leave my phone at her house and we go there. And then if she called me, then she called my best friend. So that's one way to get around it. They also would read my messages. There was a point where they had to have all my passwords. They would read my messages in my phone. So I would always delete them like all the time. To this day, I think subconsciously that is why I do this, but I always clear my history. I always delete my texts. Even if I have nothing to hide, I just do it out of habit, because I've been doing that since middle school. My mom was a teacher, so she was really like big on getting good grades, and that rubbed off on me, so thank you, Mom. But I mean, it'd be like a Friday night and she wouldn't let me go out because I'd have to finish my homework first. And it was to the point where my friends were like, if you don't want to hang out with me, just be honest. And I was like, no, I swear my mom's making me do homework. Like, they thought I was just coming up with a stupid excuse not to see them. Also, they wouldn't let me have friends over if they weren't home. Like, even girls, like, they were just weird about it. There was only like a couple friends that they knew really, really well that would let me have over when they weren't home. So there was a couple times where I had people over. Nothing weird, like we're literally just watching TV and stuff. My house was super close to the school, like walking distance before everyone drove. So we'd literally like listen for the garage door, like if my dad came home, and then everyone would scurry out the front door so they wouldn't know anyone was home. So I had to do that a lot. I don't like lying. I'm a very bad liar. Like, if my dad would have confronted me, I would have just told the truth. It was hard when, like, you know, I'm hanging out with my friends, my mom's like, I'll pick you up at 9. And like all the rest of them are sleeping over. That sucked. Like, I felt like I didn't get to see my friends a lot like other people did. Because, you know, when it's like a sleepover, you have all the fun at night when everyone's sleeping over and you do all the crazy stuff. And I just felt left out a lot of the time. I do want to say that I'm in such a great place right now, and I'm so thankful for all that my parents have done for me. And I was their first kid, and it was brand new to them. They were great parents. I had the best childhood and, you know, growing up that I could have asked for. I really don't think they could have done a better job as parents, and I love them to death. And my relationship with them has gotten so much stronger now that I'm older and more mature, and especially now that we're not living under the same house. It's like really special when I get to talk to them, because they're in Ohio, you guys. I live in California. So when I do talk to them, it's really nice, and we don't ever fight, and it just, I really miss them and I love them to death. And then when I go out there to visit, I get to spend really quality time with them. And at this point, I'm out of the house. There's not much they can do to control me, you know. They still look at my phone. They still require that I keep my location services on. I don't know why, but not like they can do anything if... I mean, I travel a lot now. I drive all over California, and my friends and I go on little trips. Like, I'm 19, you know, I'm gonna do what I want now, and I think they've accepted that. Be thankful for however your parents are raising you. It's not gonna last forever. When you move out, you're on your own. That is your freedom, and there's so many more opportunities available to you. High school is such a short period of time, and yeah, there's good memories from high school, but also there's a lot of things that they're probably protecting you from you don't even realize. I'm just so glad my parents taught me right from wrong really early. They did an amazing job parenting me. Like, I have the best mom and dad in the world, and I love them to death. And they'll watch this video, because I want to say that I'm thankful for how they raised my brother and I. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe, and leave a comment below sharing your experiences, if you guys can relay with any of the things I'm talking about with my parents. Have an awesome day. Thanks for watching. Bye.